Hey guys, I had a great idea for something here, and at the same time, I think it also might be useful, but you'll see. It's as simple as this: recommend five random games. That's it. Could be old, new, could be for the Commodore 64, could be for the PlayStation 4. Doesn't matter, it's whatever you want. All I do is recommend five random games and give a little short summary on why you recommend each one. Simple as that. Now, the other part of this is I kind of intended to design this way this is here for others to get involved is completely optional. If you don't want to go, you don't have to, but if you want to, go ahead. And if you do a video for this, if you put it in the description, you put the link to the video like you can do now, or you just tell me about it, I will put it either way. I'll put it in the description and I'll list all of you, put your name next to it here so you see who it is, and whoever comes, they want to watch it, they can. So that's it. So here we go. My five. I limited myself to only what I, systems I had, and I tried to be as varied as I could. So here we go. Now, the first one is actually the most recent one of them, but whatever. So here it is: Transformers: War for Cybertron. Yes. Now, while this is a computer version, don't worry. It's also on the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. So if you don't want to, you don't like playing on the computer, or you're just not strong enough, don't worry about it. Same game, no matter what you're playing on. Anyway. Very awesome third-person shooter. If you're into Transformers, obviously this is an easy recommendation, of course. Really good third-person shooter. Tons of combat in this. You can transform, of course, at any time, which also gives you different abilities and weapons. Tons of weapons you can find and swap out. You can only hold two, that traditional thing we have anymore. You can find many different kinds of grenades. Each Transformer has their own. They have two different abilities, which also sometimes change when you're in vehicle mode. Some are tanks, cars, trucks. Optimus is obviously a semi-truck. And certain missions allow you to play as Transformers on both the good side and bad side, Autobot and Decepticon. The jet ones like Starscream and Air Raid. Speaking of which, the main game, the campaign mode, is split into two, even though it's really one campaign. One half is Autobots, one half is Decepticons. And you do get to play as many different Autobots and Decepticons, the ones you'd expect from G1 Transformers, like Soundwave, Megatron, Optimus, Bumblebee, Sideswipe, plenty others, and there's even some new ones. There's multiplayer in this, and the main flagship mode is called Escalation, which is nothing more than like a clone of Zombies mode from Call of Duty and Horde from Gears of War, but it's still a lot of fun. And also, you can unlock two Transformers, and you can also customize your own. It's just overall, it's a very good game. Sounds great, looks great. Plays really nice. Highly recommend it. So, that's all I have to say about that one. Next one, really short and simple, Vector Man, the first one, exclusive for the Genesis Mega Drive, although there actually is a computer DOS port for it, whatever. Pretty fairly cheap game for the system too. Not that hard to find either. It's a very nice platformer. It is kind of like a side-scrolling shooter, but not that much. It's not like Gunstar Heroes. It's a little lighter on that, but it's mainly a platformer. And it has some really cool, unique looking visuals. It's what's known as rotoscope. Really nice music. You can find these items, which will allow you to transform into different forms, which allow you to do different things. They don't last forever. And it's got some pretty good boss fights, and it lasts a fair good amount of time. It's a really nice game, really fun game, pretty challenging too at certain points later on. Overall, it's not easy, really. But it's a very good game, and I highly recommend it for the Genesis Mega Drive. The second one's pretty good too, but the first one overall really is the better one, all things considered. All right, so the next one here, well, particularly I'm saying the Neo Geo version, either NVS or AES, but it was also ported to many other things, just so you know. And that is the first Samurai Showdown, also known as Spirits in Japan. Same game, different name. This is the NVS version. It's also in the AES, and I actually have another one here, so I can show you. The Genesis Mega Drive version, which is pretty good. It's also on the Super Nintendo. There's a port on the Sega CD. There's a port on the 32, 3DO, sorry. And it's also part of the Samurai Shodown Anthology compilation of the PlayStation 2. As far as I know, it's on the Neo Geo X, available for that. Of course, you can play it on MAME. There's plenty of ways to play this Neo Geo CD. There's many different ways to play this game. In fact, I think I missed a few. Anyway, the point of this, it's a really nice looking, very good playing fighting game. That's as simple as that. Looks great, plays great. It's got some awesome music. The backgrounds are really cool. Every character is different. My personal favorite's Ukyo, and it's just really awesome. And the weapons are really cool too, because you can actually knock them out of your opponent's hand. So that adds a new level of strategy to it, other than just straight up fighting. So if you lose your weapon or they lose your weapon, you might get wailed on, so you got to get it back real quick. And you can do fatalities. They're not exactly the same way as Mortal Kombat, but there's fatalities are pretty there. It's a pretty violent and gory game, bloody. So it's pretty good. Many different versions for it. So there you go. Although I'd have to say, if I'd recommend you a version, that would be the Neo Geo version itself, like the Neo Geo CD version, the MVS or AES version. You can play those on MAME, of course. Anyway, moving on. This next one is the only one of these five, which is pretty much a overlooked and underappreciated game. It's not perfect by any means. I just let you know right now. And it's Geist, an exclusive for the GameCube. This is a console first-person shooter. It's pretty good. The main thing with this, the reason I'm recommending it, other than what the two things I already mentioned, is that besides the first-person shooter part, it's got something else unique about it. Is without ruining everything about it and giving it away, because I still got to do a video talking about this sometime. You lose your physical body and you become a ghost and you float around. And you can inhabit objects and living things. And well, again, without ruining everything, you're trying to get your body back and complete what your original mission was. You can inhabit like inanimate objects like phones and buckets and stuff to scare the living people, which is what you have to do before you can inhabit them. There's a whole system that explains it really well and easy in the beginning, and it's pretty cool and unique in that way. And there's a couple other things that make it interesting too. And it has a multiplayer mode, split screen, of course, no online, and it's not exactly like it, but it's a little bit like Time Splitters. It's not as crazy or as fast and fluid as it, but it's pretty fun, and the ghost possession mechanics carry over, and there's also upgrades like make you run faster, make you jump higher, stuff like that. It's pretty fun. Good amount of weapons, and the main storyline mode lasts for a good decent while, probably about 6, 7, 8 hours. And there's just some light puzzle solving elements. It's pretty fun. And the major problem most people have with it is they like the entire game until they get to the very, very end, and that's when they basically get annoyed with it, because the ending isn't the best thing ever. That's about it. I still highly recommend it, and it's not a very expensive game for the GameCube either. Again, it's exclusive for it, so it's only on the GameCube. And the last one here is another GameCube game, but it's not exclusive to it. It's just the version I have of it. X-Men Legends 1. This is also on the original Xbox and the PlayStation 2. Again, same game no matter what you're playing it on. Very, very nice action RPG. If you're an X-Men, kind of like what I said about the Transformers one, it's right up your alley. Really, RPGs by their nature have a lot of content to them. This is no exception. There's tons of stuff to this. And one of the cool things is you can play this four-player split-screen co-op. Which, well, actually, it's not split-screen, but you get my point. Co-op is very fun in this. You play as many different X-Men. You don't get to play as Magneto, by the way. You do in the second one, which is also good. Really good. If you've played Marvel Ultimate Alliance 1 and 2, you've actually technically played this game in a way, because they pretty much took the mechanics and gameplay and all that from this. It plays and looks very much the same, except for this is only X-Men. So much to do in this. There's collectibles. You can explore the entire X-Mansion. Patrick Stewart returns to do the voice of Professor Xavier, by the way. You can play as Wolverine, Iceman, Beast, Storm, Cyclops, Jean Grey, tons of X-Men. Each one has their own moves, which they, over time, of course, as you level up, you get more and more abilities. You can upgrade their stats in any way you want, or you can have it auto do it. You can find items that can upgrade and augment your stats, and there's so much more to this. And there's a new X-Men, X-Woman, actually, that was added to this, so it's kind of interesting there, too. Boss fights galore, all kinds of stuff. It's a really good one. Second one is too. So, another game I highly recommend. Again, if you're an X-Men fan, you're something you're daring out to. And if you're not big into RPGs, by the way, because this is an action RPG, you're a lot more hands-on in the action than you would be in like a turn-based one, so keep that in mind too. Again, it's not a very hard game to come by for any of the three, and it's not a very expensive one either. The second one's slightly more expensive, just so you know. So that's it. Thanks for watching and listening. Again, it's if you wanna do one of these, go right ahead. Be really cool. Get a lot more. See, just because I did five, but someone else does a video and someone else does a video, we'll get a lot more recommendations and potentially help out some people. Who knows? And everyone's going to recommend something different. That's what I like about this. That's why I think it's interesting, you know? So, that's it. And I will see you later.